Just look through your wardrobe. What is it that you have not worn for a year? Keep that aside. And if you cannot give it all, choose at least one or two. So being spiritually rich and materialistically rich can coexist. They can go hand in hand. Sadly, many people think to be spiritually evolved, you must be poor and broke. That's so not true. When our ancestors and a holy book said that money cannot make you happy, they meant something very, very deep. Don't take my word for it. Don't take their word for it. And for that, you must learn to be materialistically rich first. And that's why in one of the Mindful Monday episodes, we're teaching you how to create a financial vision board. Have your financial goals, have your dreams, have your desires, make lots of money. Because then, with all the bags, with all the clothes, with all the luxuries, you will still be searching for that inner peace, that sense of grounding, that sense of belonging that money cannot buy. And for that, you must be spiritually rich. You will look through that illusion of money and say, oh, what am I still searching for? So how do we strike that balance? Now, materialistic growth is all about additions, right? You want more clothes, more jewels, more luxury trips, more fancy restaurants to dine at, more cars, more penthouses. But interestingly, spiritual growth is completely the opposite. It's all about subtractions. That means you give away things, you give up on things. Now, the easier bit is, of course, giving away clothes, giving away your jewels. For some, maybe that's difficult. To give away things that you're attached to, you know, belongings, materialistic things, things which are tangible. But there are other possessions that we have. And true spiritual growth is when you give away those possessions. And those possessions are like the ego, that desire to always be proven right, anger, dominating a situation, that addiction to being the center of attention, the desire to prove to others that I'm always right and you all are always wrong. These actually block your spiritual growth. So how can we give away, let go, subtract these possessions from our life? So here are some mindfulness exercises. Just look through your wardrobe. What is it that you have not worn for a year? Keep that aside. And if you cannot give it all, choose at least one or two. I haven't worn it for a year. I'm sure I don't need them. Perhaps create a spiritual pact with yourself that this year, I'm not going to shop for myself, except one outfit on Diwali, Christmas, or Eid. I know it can be very tough when you're shopping out there with your family or for your children and you see this outfit that you really, really love. You will take out your wish list and just write about that outfit. I know you'll be thinking, but it's not going to be available when it's Diwali, Eid or Christmas. But this exercise will teach you that we actually shop on impulse. 90% of the time, we shop for things that we do not need and do not even like. So giving up on these materialistic possessions is still the easier bit. For a week or two, can you give up on your ego? Anytime you come across these feelings that somebody has hurt you and somebody has upset you or said things which are sharp and you really want to retaliate, you will instantly mindfully step back and say, I'm giving up this desire to hit back, to snap at that person, to retaliate, or to give up on this tit for tat philosophy. Next time you're angry, you're going to mindfully step back, sip some water, and say, I want to spiritually grow. I want to be spiritually rich. I'm letting go of this anger. Now, you don't have to really scream and shout at that person. You can scream and shout in the restroom, in the bathroom, solitude. Go out there, punch in the air. But you have spiritually grown because you've let go of that desire to give it back to that person. In the same way, the desire to dominate or to be proven right in an argument. Whenever there's an argument at home, just step back and tell your loved ones, you know what, you are my spouse. I have no competition with you. I don't want to be proven right always. I love you. I choose to disagree, and I will let you win. This will completely shock your spouse. What's happened to her? Well, she's been watching Mindful Mondays. So these were few tips how you can be spiritually rich. Always remember, being materialistically rich and being spiritually rich can coexist. Learn to get a whole lot of wonderful goodies and then have the evolved mindset to also share and give it away. And that is the true spiritual cycle of life. So thank you for giving me all your love and attention, because that gives me the energy to give it back and share it with the rest of the world.